Jalen Rose, Anthony Davis put up 50 points against the Timberwolves, and he did it without making a single three-point shot. Jalen Rose, what do you think about him going old school and getting 50 without hitting a three?
Well, the Lakers are operating like a well-oiled machine, and players have fallen into their roles. The guys like Danny Green, who are shooters, they spot up and take their open opportunities when they come. But this is all about those two gentlemen right there, playing like two of the top five players in the game. This is why you put those guys together. And we felt like it was going to be seamless because LeBron James is one of the best passers that the league has seen, who's also a terrific scorer and improved shooter to the point where when he gets hot, it's really good. It's really impressive to watch him knock down threes. And then all of a sudden, Anthony Davis, you insert him into the mix, the drop pass for pick and rolls. You can give it to him on the block. He can spin out for lobs. He does it in the half court. He does it in transition. He's a complete basketball player, and playing with LeBron is unlocking that greatness in his game.
And, you know, I don't like to compliment you too much, but you did make a really good point last week about load management and LeBron James. The best thing to do is to get a big lead and then sit out those minutes in the fourth quarter. And what the Lakers are doing now that LeBron wasn't used to, especially in Cleveland, they maintain the lead when he's on the bench. Like, that's something that he hasn't been able to do. He had to play so many minutes for that Cleveland team, so many games for that Cleveland team. And with this Lakers team, they find a way to sometimes expand leads when he is not in the game. And Jalen, I want to show you something that he did to Gorgui Dieng. I want to show you because LeBron can still get up and down the floor and can still get up off the floor. Look at this dunk right here. Tell me what you see.
Gorgui Dieng, the walk of shame. It's when you go into shoot around at 9 in the morning and you seeing people leave that had on the clothes from the night before. That's what Gorgui Dieng has to do after this dunk by LeBron James with ferocity. But I have to say this too. Dieng playing alongside Karl Anthony Towns reminded me of the luxury that Anthony Davis now has. Remember, so many people were assassinating the character of one Rob Pelinka, and I was one person standing on the table to defend him. But there's certain lineups where you could be like, okay, we'll put AD at the four because he doesn't always like to play the five. So we could throw Dwight Howard in there, who's been defensive player of the year. We could throw JaVale McGee in there. So they could throw so many bodies at a player like Karl Anthony Towns that allows Anthony Davis to really focus on his offense and go to work.
So now we have the refs calling not one, but two delay of game calls on Chris Paul in the following game from when he got one on Jordan Bell. Do you think the refs were singling out Chris Paul and making a point?
Obviously they were, but I want to make a bigger point. It was a mistake for the officials to give Jordan Bell basically a game change and delay a game to put them on the free throw line when they played against Oklahoma. I don't care what Chris Paul knew about the rule. That was not the time to put them on the free throw line at that pivotal point of the game. So now you create a unique domino. Are we going to start calling this on a nightly basis? I watch a lot of basketball, and I see Kyrie's jersey hanging out all of the time. I can name you 50 players, including myself, who used to always have his jersey hanging out. So you trying to tell me that that's going to be something? Is that what we're doing here? So I don't like going down that path.
I don't like it either. And I think it's like Chris Paul, you know, he's obviously, you know, he knows the rules. He's a veteran. He's part of the group that's sort of like the competition committee or whatever. But here's the thing. He's checking into the game. So if you're checking into the game and the ref calls you in, then you cannot have an untucked jersey. That's how specific we are. Also, when the ref calls you into the game, it's a dead ball. So you're not even delaying the game. Like, it's just kind of silly to me, this whole thing. And I agree with you. The ref should not have made that call. And I also agree that they specifically singled him out to give him two delay of game calls in one game. And he was right. They did end up on SportsCenter.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.